Martínez, and I am from Mexico, Chapala, Jalisco. Hola, soy Jenny Martínez y ahora les voy a enseñar una receta que mi mamá nos enseñó y nos pasó. I'm going to be showing you a recipe that my mom became pretty famous with it. This is a tradition that she passed down to us. Let's get started. So now I'm going to show you how my mom prepares for birria with all these amazing spices. And yes, there are a lot, but I promise you at the very end, it's going to be so delicious and it's so worth it. It's just gathering the ingredients really, but at the end, everything comes together and it's really, really simple. This is one of the recipes that put me on the map. I pretty much became famous on TikTok thanks to my daughter. She says, Mom, you need to get on TikTok and you need to start showing your recipes there. People love authentic Mexican food. So the very first day that we uploaded this video, it went viral. I think we got over 2 million views on this the very first night. And we were so excited and the people wanted to see more. So this is how Jenny started. So let me go over the ingredients. First off, we're gonna be using chile guajillos, which is this one here, and then it's not spicy at all. Now we have chile pasilla, which kind of looks like a dried prune, but just make sure that when you are working with this chile, this is chile seco, just make sure you take out all the seeds and you take out all the little veins because you don't want that in this stew. We're gonna be using chile, this is chile puya. And then this is optional. This one right here is chile de árbol. This one's really, really spicy, so you have to be careful. Depending on the level of heat that you'd like to eat your food, you could throw it in or just leave it out. It's totally up to you. Now we're gonna be using some fresh ginger. Here we have some dried oregano, some cumin, some toasted sesame seeds, some white vinegar, garlic, and this is a ground cumin and some onion. So the way that you want to start cooking this meat, you're gonna be using the chuck beef roast. You get your chuck, you put it in the pot, you fill it up with water as long as you're covering the meat. Then you throw it with a piece of onion, you put some bay leaf, some garlic, and some salt while you're cooking it, and that's gonna give the meat the internal flavor that you want. All of these beautiful chiles, all these spices, that's where you get that authentic Mexican taste. You see that? That's what's gonna give the color. So you're gonna let that cook for an hour. Once you're done with cooking that meat for an hour, then that's when you start hydrating your chiles. And that's how you make this beautiful stew. My mom was the person to go to, and she wouldn't charge them. It was just something in Mexico, pretty much like a sponsor. She would sponsor the food. Once we moved to California, my mom started making the birrias for our parties, our weddings, our quinceañeras, and also all of our friends and families would come to her. I thought it was really, really hard to make, but once I started doing it for the very first time, I realized it was really easy. It's just gathering all the ingredients. So now you guys are gonna be in for a treat because I'm gonna show you how to make the famous quesabirria tacos. So now let's start getting the meat out because we need to chop it. And then having a little fat in the meat is okay because that's what's gonna give it the flavor. So once you start chopping it up, just like this, very lightly, just be careful, don't make a mess. So now look at this. We're gonna get our tortilla. Get a little oil, get your comal ready, have it nice and hot. Just put a little bit of oil. You're gonna dip your tortilla inside of the stew, and then that way you could also give the tortilla some flavor. So make sure this is nice and warm. You see that? That's what you wanna hear. You wanna hear that sizzle. You do not wanna put a tortilla onto cold oil, otherwise it's gonna get soggy. All right, so now let's get some of this meat. Put it on your taco and get your favorite cheese out. I'm gonna be using queso cotija, and look how easily it just peels. Look at this, beautiful. As much as you want, just like that. And now you flip, like this. Just make sure that the cheese and everything is nicely secured inside your taco. And this is the famous quesabirria taco that everybody goes crazy for when you go to Mexico. So again, this birria recipe, my mom is the one that passed it down to me. I remember I was 13 years old when I would think it would be impossible to learn this recipe. And with this whole COVID and the pandemic, we wanted her birria and we couldn't see her. So I said, you know what? It's about time that I get started doing this on my own. And sure enough, look at that cheese, look at that. Oh my gosh. Let me see if I can get that cheese just oozing out. Look at that. Oh my God. That's what we go crazy for. All right, so this one is ready. I'm gonna serve it here. There you go. Listo.